There's the Alphonsus, who's the founder, the lawyer, the great moral theologian, the great confessor, the musician, the artist. And I find it, you know, I admire and I thank God for all of the gifts that Alphonsus gave to the church and the world. But I don't identify with him as closely as Alphonsus the bishop. But let me explain why. Because Alphonsus didn't want to be a bishop. You know, he kept putting the Pope off, and claiming his health wouldn't stand it. And finally, the Pope said to his secretary, write to Liguori and tell him that if he dies, we'll give him a nice funeral. If he's alive, he's to be a bishop. So I think that I shared, and still do, you know, that feeling of being ripped out of the community, which is a suffering. But I look at Alphonsus and what he did as a bishop in a very backwater, poor diocese in central Italy, and produced wonderful pastoral direction for the church in the 18th century. So I suppose what, you know, I still cry at Christmas when they play Tuscende dalle Stelle here in our cathedral, and we have so many Italians here, they know how to sing it. I miss the community every day. But Alphonsus gives me the courage to kind of soldier on, knowing that if it's God's will, when I submit my letter of resignation, I hope to be a burden again on a Redemptorist community.